Hello chickens. Today we have just a short video about chemical reactions, just sort of a little introductory thing. You guys have already gotten your feet wet with the intro to writing word equations worksheet. So this is just to sort of tie things together and provide a couple more examples so that you can complete the next set of activities. So I guess the first question is really, what is a chemical reaction? Really, it's just a chemical change. So the atoms and molecules are rearranging themselves and creating new molecules. We still have the same atoms that we started with. They're just being rearranged. So since we are creating new molecules from the old molecules, this is a bond breaking slash bond making process. We might have to break bonds in the beginning molecules so that we can reform them in different ways in the products for the molecules that we make at the end. And these chemical reactions occur around you all the time. In fact, right this very second, a chemical reaction, thousands of chemical reactions are occurring in your body. So we have cellular respiration. It's where we take in sugar and oxygen, and it gives us energy. And then we exhale carbon dioxide. In plants, this is called photosynthesis, right? So in photosynthesis, it's the opposite of cellular respiration. And this is how plants get their energy. They take in carbon dioxide and water and sunlight, and they create oxygen. And then we breathe in that oxygen, and it's a very nice symbiotic process. Well, I don't know. You might have to ask a biology teacher on my use of that term, but save it for next year. And there are tons more chemical reactions occurring from how you got to school today, probably via car or bus. Even just brushing your teeth, that was a chemical reaction. So how can we be sure that a chemical reaction is occurring? Hopefully you remember these signs from last semester when we first learned about chemical changes, but there are four main signs that we looked at, and that's spontaneous gas formation, so the creation of a gas when there wasn't previously a gas, a spontaneous temperature change, either increase or decrease, spontaneous color change, so adding food coloring is not a spontaneous color change. Or the formation of a precipitate. So that's when you have two solutions that you mix together and it forms a solid. And so we saw this last semester when we mixed two clear solutions and they formed like a cloudy white precipitate. And we'll do some more labs with these chemical reactions and you'll get to see all of these in person again. But you do need to know of these four signs of a chemical reaction. Technically, odor change is a fifth sign, but that doesn't always work. So you kind of got to watch that one a little bit more. But that is a possible sign of a chemical reaction. So how do we write these chemical reactions? Well, there's some important terms that you need to know. Right? We've got the reactants and we've got the products. What I want you to think of is chemical reactions kind of like a recipe. So your reactants are the stuff that you're mixing together in order to create whatever it is you're trying to create. And that would be your product. So when you make a cake, you're mixing cake mix, eggs, oil, I don't know what else is in cake, and your final product is that cake. And then it looks totally different than it did when it started. But for chemistry, we have to be a little bit more specific about the types of things that we're dealing with. We need to include the states of matter of everything that we deal with, so solid, liquid, gas, or AQ is aqueous, which means that we have a solution. So aqueous means solution. This is when acids and ionic compounds dissociate. So let's look at this first example here. Zinc metal reacts with hydrochloric acid to produce zinc chloride solution and hydrogen gas. I'm just going to break this down for you, starting here with zinc metal. So the chemical symbol for zinc is Zn, and it says it's a metal, which tells us that we are in the solid state. Then it says reacts with. So I'm going to put a plus sign saying like, hey, this zinc is combining with something else. Hydrochloric acid, I'm just going to tell you right now, this is a formula that you need to memorize. It's HCl, but you could figure that out by going from hydro, ic, and using your naming acid rules. And all acids are going to be considered aqueous unless you're told otherwise. Then it says to produce, which tells me, hey, now I need my arrow signifying that now I'm switching to the products. And it says I produced zinc chloride solution. Zinc always has a 2+ charge. So when I form this product, it should be ZnCl2 in order to balance out the charges. And it says that it's a solution. Again, solutions are aqueous because we've got now an ionic compound that we're dealing with here. And last but not least, we have hydrogen gas. Now, hydrogen, you got to be careful with. It's one of your diatomics. Don't forget your diatomics, Hof-Brinkel. I will make you yell it when I come back. I do have another example. Carbonic acid decomposes, which means breaks down, into liquid water and carbon dioxide gas. So the first thing you need to know is the formula for carbonic acid, which, again, you can use your naming rules to figure that out. It's H2CO3. And it says decomposes. So I'm just already going to draw the arrow. It seems like carbonic acid is my only reactant. And what I form is liquid water and carbon dioxide gas. So you'll notice here that I wrote all the formulas, and now I'm going to go back in and add the states of matter. You can do whatever works for you. Add the states of matter as you go, or fill it in after you've written the formulas. Again, this is an acid. All acids are aqueous. It says we have liquid water, and it says we have carbon dioxide gas. That's really all you need to know for writing chemical equations. All the other tips and tricks are listed on the new worksheet that you have for practicing writing these equations. So make sure you grab that and complete it. When you're done with that activity, we're going to move on to balancing. Good luck.